Hello viewers, welcome to Bulls vs Bears Trading Academy. I hope you all are making profits from the support and resistance areas given one day prior. Before starting the video, let's see a small disclaimer. So if you are a new subscriber, subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon. You can join the Telegram and WhatsApp group from the link given in the description box. So this is a link for Telegram group and the WhatsApp group. So on this channel, we validate the support and resistance areas given one day prior, and we will analyze Nifty for next day also. So this was the intraday movement of Nifty on November 1st, 2019. And this is the intraday movement of Nifty today, that is November 4th, 2019. The level given was, the resistance zone given was 11942-955, given at yesterday 9:13 PM. So the range was 11942-955. We'll check the range. Sorry. Here the range is 11940-11954. So this was the range given one day prior. If you just remove the range, this is how it looked like. We do not know where the buying is occurring and where the selling is occurring. If you want to learn to trade like a professional, we need to use the zones. So most retailers in the market would be using a 15-minute range breakout. Here the time frame is 5 minute. So here it is our first 5 minute candle, second, third. This becomes a 15-minute range for most of the traders. If you just make this 15 minute. So here now the time frame is 15 minute. I have changed the time frame to 15 minute. So here is our first 15 minute candle. Most people would be entering the market at this range only to trade the opening range breakout, but if we add our zones, this is how it becomes. So if we just add our zones, we are entering the market at this position. So if you want to learn to trade like a professional, we need to use the support and resistance areas given by me. So this is the first 5 minute candle. We went up here, it formed an intraday zone where prices was trading within the high and low. Within the high and low of this green candle, 1 2 3 4 5 candles were trading within the high and low of this green candle. So 5 candles into 5 minute time frame is equal to 25 minutes. So for 25 minutes they were trading within the high and low of this candle. Here it formed a candlestick pattern, morning star. Remember this morning star pattern: a red candle followed by a neutral candle and a green candle. A red candle followed by two neutral candles and a green candle. So here it started settling over this. It came down to take support from the lower end of the zone and it went up. As it went up, it started taking support over the upper end. So for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 candles into 5 minutes is equal to 55 minutes. It took support over the upper end. So if we use these zones, we are entering the trade at this position. If we trade like a retailer and trade based on a opening range breakout, we are entering it at this position. So the difference is we are missing this 25 points up move. This is what keeps a difference between the retailers and the professionals. So if you just enter here and trail our profits till we get a if we just trail the profits of the lows of every candle, we would be getting a 25 points up move. That's enough for intraday. 25 points into lot size of the Nifty is 75. So one could take around 2.5k. So it came down. Again, it formed an intraday zone here with this candle. Within the high and low of this green candle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 9 candles into 5 minutes. 45 minutes it traded within the high and low of this green candle. It gave a breakout. One could have initiated a trade over here or waited for a retest. If I had initiated a trade over here, your stop loss would have been the low of this green candle below 11905. So 20 points is a stop loss. Stop loss you would have to place. It came down to test this level and it went up. Here you can see so many bullish candlestick patterns. Bullish candlestick pattern, a wick at the bottom. Bearish candlestick pattern, a wick at the top. And a neutral candle will be having both up and down wicks. So here we can see so many bullish candlestick pattern. It went up. It went up only to take resistance from the upper end of the zone. Here we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 candles into 5 minutes. 45 minutes it took resistance at the upper end of the zone and it fell down. So this was the intraday movement of Nifty with respect to the zones. And if you want to trade like a professional, you need to use the support and resistance zones. So the resistance and the support analysis for tomorrow. So the support zones are, support and resistance zones are these. Make a screenshot. If you are watching this video, give it a thumbs up to encourage and support us. This is the only thing you can do to support us. So please make a screenshot of this and apply them onto your charts. If you are a new subscriber, subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon. I have posted some articles in the group yesterday. So this is a standard surfactants limited company's fundamentals posted in the news Economics Time newspaper in 1994. It was collected from one of our neighbors. And the other is, sorry. So the other is Sri Krishna Polyester Limited. Here it is written as sorry, sales double, net profit triple, unaudited financial results for the year end 31st March 1994. So this is Sri Krishna Polyester Limited, which is still trading in the Bombay Stock Exchange. And the other is, so this is Nova Rail Group. This was issued to the shareholders. It was issued in the year 1994, September 14. So here it is written, dear shareholder, it is indeed a pleasure to for me to take this opportunity to communicate developments in Nova RG Group. So it is Nova Iron and Steel Limited, sponge iron plant of Nova Iron and Steel Limited has been completed. The trial runs are in the progress and commercial products is expected to commence within this month. So they were expanding their business and it was a letter from the company to the shareholders. So the director at the time was G.K. Gambhir. Nova Steels India Limited, registered address New Delhi and corporate address New Delhi. And this one is Piccadilly Sugars, which is still trading in the Bombay Stock Exchange. It was issued in the year 1994. This was a Piccadilly shares application form. So here you can see application with stock invest issued prior something. And if you just closely look at this, we can see so many columns. It is not visible over here. We need to fill this form and just we need to put it in the put an application to them to get shares issued. So this was a rare collection. I got them and still I have many from 1990s collection. So this was a validation and analysis for today. Support and encourage us through your likes and comments. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.